Hey people, my Lulzbot Taz-free glass print bed is currently in pieces, and all I have is this piece of plywood. So I asked myself, can you 3D print directly onto wood? Watch to find out. Now there's some obvious problems with using wood as a substrate. For starters, it's not a stable material and it will bend under pressure, as well as shrink and expand with humidity and temperature changes. And it's also flammable, so introducing a hot metal tip that's as hot as 300 degrees C onto it will obviously cause burns, but it's also awesome. And those who know me will know that I love wood and I think there's nothing that it can't do. Now, plywood significantly mitigates the issues with wood movement as it's fairly strong and uses a cross grain lattice. So it seems like the logical choice for us to experiment with that. And I also happen to have a sheet of 6mm plywood, which is about 298 by 298mm. Which happens to fit directly onto the Taz without even me having to cut any wood. So let's give this a try. And now I'm not expecting the printer's hot end to cause the sheet to instantly burst into flames, of course, but I'm not leaving this print unattended and I'm not squishing the hot end too far onto the bed because if it does touch the bed, this will cause some burning. Now my thoughts are the natural pores of the wood will make the plastic stick extremely well, possibly to the point where it becomes destructive to remove the print afterwards. However, I'm going to try a few variations on the rough wood as possible surfaces. First of all, we'll try some PVA glue on one spot as that will seal the wood and it works really well on a normal glass bed. We'll also try some ABS juice. So that's an ABS and acetone mix that I often use for prints. Now the acetone should evaporate off, leaving a very thin layer of plastic. Now if you've never seen this stuff before, it's really easy to make. Just melt your ABS plastic into a tub of acetone and leave it in a sealed HDPE or some other non-reactive plastic tub. Clearly marked, of course, so you don't accidentally drink it. And it's perfect for getting rid of your old failed prints. We'll use wood glue as that should make a nice smooth surface and again close up some of the pores in the wood. And of course we'll try bare wood with nothing on. Our test print will be the Lulzbot Roctopus as it's a familiar print that doesn't take too long. And we'll plate up four of them in Cura and use the fast ABS profile and of course turn the print bed heater off since it's currently a sheet of wood and not a heater. The bare wood is actually the first one to become unstuck, which really surprises me. I think we should stop here though, because the first test is clearly yielding some good results. The wood glue isn't great either, with some lifting on the octopus legs. Oh, and the PVA glue isn't great either. The ABS juice, however, is stuck on great, and in fact, has just taken a tiny bit of wood with it on removal. Okay, all of the prints can now go into the hat of fail. Let's now try a double-sized roctopus full print on the ABS juice-coated plywood. Okay, that's stuck on fairly well. In fact, actually it's pretty stuck on there. I'm going to have to use my delicate 3D print removal tool. Okay, it's taking a little bit of the wood with it, but not enough to damage the plywood sheet and not enough for it to leave a really nasty bottom layer. I think a bit of sanding and this will be okay. So this answers the question, can I print directly onto wood, right? Well, okay, technically I'm printing onto a really thin film of ABS plastic. Is that cheating? I don't know. Should I try some different woods, perhaps, without any of the plastic juices? I don't think it's worth it, but if you disagree, let me know in the comments below. Now, I think it's also stuck on far better than I had planned, as the ABS juice probably seeped into the pores and grabbed on really tight, like the roots of a tree. Now, maybe I could try some sanding sealer, sand the sheet smooth, and then use the ABS juice to prolong the life of the plywood sheet, but that seems like a lot of effort for a sheet of plywood when I'm going to replace the whole bed anyway eventually. Now, obviously, I could use some PEI tape, Captain tape or blue painter's tape to put onto the wood, but that's definitely not printed on wood, is it? There's no grey area there. So printing directly onto wood was a necessity for me, as I'm currently without a proper print bed, but there's got to be some other applications for this. Now, I can only think of artistic uses, and I've been messing around with that a little, but there's bound to be some other good ideas out there. If you have any thoughts, any feedback is welcome in the comments below. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, share the video, and also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And remember to click the notification bell if you want to be told about new videos that I'm putting out. If anybody wants to give me a new print bed, that's not a scrap of plywood, that'll be cool too. Thanks all.